What a big difference you're making if you're praying and supporting the work of New Life Evangelistic Center. Whether it's at 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, Missouri, 1411 Locust Street in St. Louis, or a host of other locations, including India, Africa, what a difference for good. Be sure you stay tuned, see it for yourself. I'm Larry Rice, and this is Here's Help. There's so many hurting and homeless people, and they're coming to New Life Evangelistic Center at this time. Joining me is Jonah. And Jonah came to us from our 806 North Jefferson facility in Springfield, Missouri. And Jonah, you're here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. You found yourself homeless. How has New Life been helping you?
New Life's been helping me out extremely. They're giving me a place to stay, room and board, and not just that, but making me into a better person by helping me help others.
Are they really?
Yeah.
Tell us, you were homeless, and were you sleeping outside?
I did a couple of nights. I did a few nights.
Wow. There's a lot of people sleeping outside in Springfield in there.
Yes, quite a bit.
And there's a lot of them sleeping outside in St. Louis. And in St. Louis, they're trying to pass a law that if you go out and help the people that are sleeping outside, the police can write you a ticket. Are you aware of that? It's Board Bill 66. They first went after the homeless. Now they're going after the churches, the people of God. Board Bill 66 that is now before the St. Louis Board of Aldermen. Thank God for those that are speaking up and speaking out concerning this. Well, we'll go to Harold Hendricks. He does a regular radio show on KSIV, a minister. It's been a leader in this community for a long time. Harold, tell us what you think about that.
I'm Harold Hendrick. My visibility is primarily with Bot Radio. I have done Bot Radio part-time for 27 years. And my website is harolhendrick.com, where I have several hundred interviews up there. You can go there and find Larry Rice, do a search for Larry Rice, or Ray Redlick, or Judy Redlick, people like that, names that you know. But I'm here in support of the effort of to resist an effort to, as Ray Redlick says, criminalize efforts to help the homeless. It's just insane. It's crazy. And frankly, I think when this meets the light of day with the Constitution, it won't stand a chance. But some are inclined to take it as far as they can and hope it might fly. I don't think it'll fly. When we try simply to exercise religious liberty, when people hand out blankets and water to try to make them have a license under the risk of penalty if they don't pay, it's out of sight. It's un-American. And so I'm supporting Ray Redlick and Larry Rice in their efforts to resist this. I know that from the rich people's point of view, a cluster of homeless people may be unpleasant, but they're homeless, and Jesus loves them. I'm just an appreciation of trying to do the right thing, and I will join them using my radio opportunity and my influence, whatever it is, to resist these efforts to try to encroach on religious liberty in an unconstitutional fashion. Thankfully, we still live in a free country where I'm acquainted with Matt Staver of Liberty Council, that's LG.com, I think, who has been before the Supreme Court on issues like this. And I think I know of other attorneys and national groups that have crews of lawyers defending religious liberty. So I think we're trying to nip this in the bud, but if it gets very far, we've got some national legal resources that will help us do the right thing. We want to honor Jesus. I'm getting older. I just got who knows how much time I have left, but I'd like to finish the course in strength. You know, David, even King David didn't finish as strong as he should. Solomon didn't. I'm hoping that I will be among those who are going to finish the course serving our Lord Jesus Christ in his strength and in his power. So thank you for letting me make this statement, and I appreciate again what New Life Evangelistic Center is doing to help the homeless, providing shelter overnight. I understand it's the only place where people can walk in at, you know, say midnight and say, I need help, I need a place to sleep, and they can come right in. And efforts to stymie that are horrible, too. So anyway, the Lord bless you watching, and may we ever stand up for the right and for righteousness. Thank you very much.
Harold, sharing from you as a result of a recent luncheon that we had. It was an exciting day where we gathered together, and ministers and caring people from all over that cared about the homeless came. They talked about the different works they were doing. We all came together as one against this injustice. And that's what is an injustice, trying to stop people from what Jesus has told them to do in Matthew chapter 25 and many other places in Scripture. How I thank God for those who are speaking up and speaking out. Ministers coming forward. Jerome Bracely was a man that's once homeless. In fact, he came to New Life Evangelistic Center. They used to call him Possum. He got involved in the New Life Evangelistic Center training program. The Lord did a total turnaround in his life. And he went forth from here, and we helped him get Stepping in the Light started. And so many men have gone through his program. We really thank God for what he's done in Jerome Bracely's life, minister now, serving the Lord. Jerome also shared with us how he felt about this Board Bill 66.
I'm here supporting the work of the homeless and what God has called Larry Rice to do, and that's to help the homeless. Over 45 years, and I tell you, he helped me, because at one time I was homeless myself, and I can relate to a person out there that are homeless and hungry. There's been times in my own life when I had to go to the shelter myself when I didn't have no food, and they offered me a sandwich, and it really sustained me. And right now, I know what the word of the Lord says when it says, when I was hungry, did you feed me? When I was thirsty, did you give me anything to drink? When I was naked, did you clothe me? When I was in prison or sick, did you come and visit me? And he said, inasmuch you've done to at least one of these, my brothers, you've done it unto me. And I want to thank God that Larry Rice and New Life Evangelist Center was there in my time of need. Not only my time of need, but a lot of people's time of need. And so I'm here to support the work that God has called him to do. I mean, he's ordained to do this. So many people I've helped, I've been helped through his ministry. And because of the help that he's given me, God has allowed me to help over 10,000 men, besides women and children, men being restored and reconciled back to their families so they can be in a rightful position like God has put me in my rightful position. I thank God. I didn't realize I was going to be used like this, but I know the Bible says, for God does not see as man sees. Man looks on the outward, but God looks at the heart. What God saw, he saw my heart was broken. And I cried out to him, Lord, deliver me from this homelessness and this drugs and alcohol, this sinful lifestyle. And I commit my life to you. And that's what I'm doing right now. Men are being helped through my ministry. They're being restored back to their wives and children. It's fulfilling when you see a man with his son and his daughters, and they hugging him, and the only thing you see is just tears flowing because of restoration and rejoicing. And there's no words. So I thank God for this ministry, and I thank God for the work that he's called Larry and Ray to do. And he is using me too in that same field. So help support the work here at New Life Evangelistic Center, and help get on board to help the homeless. God bless you.
I thank God for those that are standing with us at this time against this injustice. And Jonah, what do you think about that? Trying to make a law that if you go out and feed the hungry or help the homeless or do what Jesus told you to do, and they can write you a ticket or put you in jail for it.
I think that should be against the law if you're helping the homeless.
Yeah, they want to try to say you have to get a vendor's license in the city of St. Louis. In order to get a vendor's license, it either costs you $200 or $500. And the real catch is this, that the director of the streets department can't and parks department can't give it to you unless he gets permission from the Downtown St. Louis Partnership, which is a group that got the alderman to introduce the legislation in the first place. And if by way of miraculous events, you did get that vendor's license, the law explicitly says if you help anybody between 11 p.m. and 6 a.m., you're violating the law. So on the cold winter nights, we go out and we find people that are on winter patrol, carrying people going throughout the community, and find somebody and give them a blanket or bring them into shelter and help them in any way. The police see them, they can lock them up for it. So something's wrong with all of that. And Jonah, to help people understand, what is it like being homeless? And in this case, we've talked a lot about St. Louis, but you're being in Springfield, Missouri. What's it like? Is it easy to get in trouble when you're homeless?
Yeah, you can get in trouble because they just don't know what you're up to. Being homeless, it's not a good feeling. You're living day to day, and it's just not comfortable living. You're not just not knowing what you're going to do, what that day really holds when you walk outside the door.
So from day to day, you don't know what's going to happen.
Right. And it's a day to day from like not when you're working with a plan versus you're living day to day. Like, what does today bring?
Throws you totally into the arms of the Lord.
Yes.
And as you were there, were you praying?
I did, but not like I should have. I was praying, but I did more meditation.
Well, somehow you ended up at our facility, 806 North Jefferson in Springfield. How did that happen?
Well, I happened to go to one of your other facilities or something. And I talked to a guy named Chester. He was telling me that this was a biblical...
Well, that's the 806. Chester works at our facility at 806 North Jefferson, Springfield.
Yeah.
How did you end up getting to that place?
How did I end up... Oh, a gentleman came up to me and said, hey, would you like to volunteer? And I said, sure, why not? And I said, I can do something. I felt like doing something good. I didn't have a roof over my head or anything, so not having a roof over my head, nothing to eat, guaranteed I could stay somewhere where I could be sheltered. So if it takes a little bit to give back, I'm...
So you got involved, became involved there in Springfield. They brought you to St. Louis. You got involved in our 30-day program. You're out looking for work. You volunteer a few hours. And you feel like you're drawing closer to God through all that?
I do. I do. I feel really good when I'm helping out. Really good when I'm helping out.
Praise God. And we want to give you that opportunity to get that good feeling by volunteering at the New Life Evangelistic Center. You can do that. You can call us at 1-800-334-3276. 436-2424. If you're in Springfield, you can volunteer at our facility there at 806 North Jefferson in Springfield, Missouri, or in St. Louis, Potosi, any one of the New Life Evangelistic Center locations. There's opportunities awaiting you. I also praise God for what He's doing through so many other groups. And many of them gathered together with us at the recent luncheon I made reference to earlier. I want to go to Ray. Pastor Ray is on the New Life team, who is going to talk to one of the individuals that's on the front lines helping the homeless through the work of God in their area.
I'm talking with Pastor Goatley of the Calvary Missionary Baptist Church. Is that
yes,
correct?
Yes, sir.
And you've been located right at the edge of the downtown area for your church for many years.
We just celebrated our 100th church anniversary, and we've basically been in the same block for 100 years.
Wow.
Yeah.
And I know your church is not satisfied with just being there and just holding services, but you are also helping the homeless in a very important way. Tell us about what the Calvary Missionary Baptist Church has been doing there.
Well, I want to say we have built upon missions that the church was doing before I got there. I've been there 11 years, and you know, we still do a food pantry. We've been feeding what we call the feeding the hungry. But we've been participating in the Winter Outreach Network for the past 5 years. We have a gym. We take in at least three nights a week during the winter months, up to 100 men, women, and children. We have wonderful volunteers that feed them a hot dinner, a hot breakfast. We give out clothes, underwear, whatever people need, socks, showers. So we are invested in helping the homeless. I appreciate Pastor Rice convening this meeting of pastors and faith leaders. I don't believe poor people should be criminalized. I don't believe homeless people should be criminalized. And I don't believe if you want to help somebody who is down on their luck, you shouldn't become a criminal. So I just believe this bill that's being considered by the Board of Aldermen, it doesn't make common sense. Other cities have tried it. They've been taken to court. The law has been struck down. I don't see any reason for doing it, other than the fact that maybe a half dozen homeless people somebody doesn't care to see. But being poor is not a crime. Being homeless is not a crime. And I just think common sense should prevail, that people shouldn't become arrested just because they want to help somebody who needs help.
What a blessing it is to just get together with brothers and sisters in the Lord. If you'd like to know, we're going to have our next luncheon. Call 314-881-3218. That's 314-881-3218. Coming together of people that are helping the homeless and those that would like to help the homeless more and those that want to help stop injustices concerning the homeless and legislation that continues to keep people down and penalize those that want to help those in need. I refer to the Board Bill 66 now before the St. Louis Board of Public Aldermen as the anti-Good Samaritan bill. Anti-Good Samaritan bill. We have some that have gotten up and talked and said, it shouldn't just be 666, it should be 666, because this is a real mark of the beast. And this mark of the beast is totally part of the Antichrist because it's totally anti-Christ, everything that Jesus taught. Well, I don't know if I'd go quite that far, but what I would say is that those folks are certainly misled, and we need to pray for them. We need to pray for them. Well, I thank God for those of you that are praying for us here at New Life Evangelistic Center. Those of you that are sharing this New Life Evangelistic Center, P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. You can also give online at newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. Thank you for caring and sharing at this critical hour. Let's hear from others.
Hello, my name is Jesse Robinson, and I'm glad to be a part of this luncheon and support Reverend Larry Rice and in support of his ministry, feeding the hungry and sheltering the hungry people, and his fight for the rights of those people. And I ask your prayers and support of all of you that will have a heart and mind to support this ministry, and that God will bless you and keep you, because he said, feed the hungry, clothe the naked. That'll be a step one. So there's many things you can do. You can call Reverend Rice and see what needs he would like for you to do. And Reverend Rice will tell you, and he'll let you know all the things that he needs and how you can support his ministry. God bless you and keep you.
My name is Jennifer Ganella, and I'm here to support Larry Rice and the missions. And I'm just going to stand up for the homeless people. They need help. And I think this bill is very silly. And, you know, they deserve rights just like we do. A little over about 4 or 5 years ago, God has called me and my husband to feed the homeless. And that's exactly what we're doing. Please don't take that away from us.
Praise God. It's an honor to be here today. We are meeting to talk about this bill the city is trying to pass, Bill 66. It is a tremendous outrage, and it's going to affect all types of things. So as we try to help the homeless, I encourage the churches and the state and the city to get behind us and cancel this bill. We need to be advocates of the homeless, not hinderers. God bless you all. Thank you. My name is Pastor Paul.
My name is Junior White from the Coffin Free Methodist Church in Illinois. I stand up on this matter to make this not happen on this ordinance. I just pray that God just makes the city think about this and change their mind. And I stand up with this whole county here and our Christian families that we need to feed the homeless, and we need to stand up and clothe them and do whatever we need to do for the homeless as well as doing for others. And I give this and I pray the God that make it happen. Amen.
If you'd like to get a copy of Board Bill 66, give us a call, 881-3218. Again, we'll get you a complete copy of that. We'll give you some literature. We'll even give you the names of those on that committee that are going to be hearing this bill. It's 314-881-3218. Jonah is joining me at this time, and Jonah comes from Springfield, Missouri, where New Life Evangelistic Center has a large program there. Many of you aren't familiar with the work in Springfield, Missouri. It's the largest daytime walk-in shelter during the day that homeless people come in. They've got computers, don't they? Jonah, they have a free store, they got meals, you can do your laundry, you can store belongings. If homeless have been up all night long, they can take naps.
Mm-hmm.
It's a place for them to fellowship.
Mm-hmm.
They got a library.
Yep.
A bunch of stuff, don't they?
Yep. They got everything you said.
All of that that was there. Mm-hmm. So you came in, utilized some of that stuff. And how did you? You've been homeless off and on during the last 6 months. How did you end up homeless?
Like I said, I was incarcerated. I had a warrant out for my arrest and forgot about it. And I just for the description of another person, they ran my name. I was working at the time. I had my own place. And I just went to jail and I got it taken care of because before I came here, they did a police search on me. They mm-hmm. had to do that to make sure I was okay.
But ultimately, it ended up you being homeless for a while.
Yeah. I was homeless when I got out of jail because I didn't have anything. Everything was gone. My apartment, my vehicle, everything was gone.
Where does a person go when they come to the end of themselves? Many of them come here, and our resources are so limited this time, brothers and sisters. I'm coming to you asking you to please pray for a financial miracle of $500,000. Now, that's a lot more money than you have, I have, or any of us have probably, but we can pray it in. I'm coming to you asking you for prayer. I'm asking you to get down before God and call out on the Lord right now. Please call out on Him. Tell Him, yes, call out. He says, ask, it shall be given you. Seek, and you shall find. Knock, and it shall be opened unto you. I thank God for you prayer warriors. Ask, seek, find. Pray for us. We need your prayers here at New Life Evangelistic Center at this time. Please go to God and pray for the financial needs. Pray for God to raise up dedicated laborers for what is referred to as this vast harvest of souls, lost lives, people in need. Please pray for us right now at the New Life Evangelistic Center. Please, it'd be just so wonderful to know that you're praying. You can write me. And maybe the Lord's laid a scripture on your heart that you'd like to share with me at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri. That's 63166. Hearing from all of you is just so encouraging. Thank God for those of you that are praying and sharing at this particular time through the love of Jesus.
My name is Reverend Smith, and I really appreciate Transformation Church and World Outreach and New Life Evangelical Center, Brother Rice, for inviting us out today and that we might pray and set up a plan where we might be led by God's Spirit to overcome the evil one that is trying to keep us from doing what God would have us to do, feed the hungry, shelter the homeless, clothe the naked, and we pray that God would be glorified today. And I thank God that I'm a part of this, and we pray that God would be glorified.
Reverend Rice, I wanted to tell you thank you. I just wanted to tell you thank you. I came to St. Louis in 1991, and when I came here, I didn't have a place to stay. Someone told us about your ministry. We went to your ministry, and we were able to stay with you. And something had happened in the house that we were staying in, and you had gave us finances to be able to stay at a hotel. And I just want to thank you, because that was a foundation for us when I came to St. Louis, and I've been at Transformation ever since then. So I wanted to tell you again, thank you.
I thank God for all of you and your words of encouragement and your prayers. Words cannot express how much and how important it is. Please pray for me, my son Chris, Brother Ray, all the staff here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. Yes, please pray for us at these times. These are difficult times, but I know that Jesus is Lord. And I thank God for those of you that are standing up against Board Bill 66 with us at this moment. Appreciate each one of you. Let's hear from another brother.
My name is Stephen Howard, Coffeen, Illinois. I believe that we should witness and help everybody that needs to be helped. Jesus didn't turn anybody away in the Bible. He didn't care what they looked like and what they had, and he always witnessed everybody. Like they said, the guy spoke about feeding the 5,000. If Jesus had gone out and get a permit and everything else, they wouldn't have got fed and everything by the time the paperwork cleared. It's our duties as Christians to witness to the people of the world and help these people. And I pray for them every day, and God bless them all.
We're here today to come and to show our support and to stand on the injustices to our homeless brothers and sisters who are at this time less fortunate than us. But we believe that if we rally together, the bill that the aldermen are trying to pass, that the homeless cannot be fed in downtown. I think that's just cruel because you never know when you may be in the same predicament, because that just may be you on the other side of the fence. And so we're here making a statement, coming and collaborating with other religious and civic leaders in the city to be able to come with a suggestion and come with an answer. And we believe that it could happen.
Thank you. Thank you, brothers and sisters, for praying for us at this time here at the New Life Evangelistic Center. Thank you for standing with us. Thank you for caring and sharing. We're also trying to help support so many other groups that are doing a wonderful work out there on the front lines. We're standing together, working together, praying together. And may God bless you for partnering with us at this time. I want you to hear from this pastor and what he's doing.
Hi, I'm Pastor Gene Dunkley, and I'm with my brothers from the Caffeine Free Methodist Church. And we are involved in ministry to the hungry in Caffeine. And we're very concerned because this is a commission that God has given to his people. What does it mean to be a follower of Christ? It's not just about Sunday service. It's about what we do every single day, every single hour, 24/7, 365 days. And God has commissioned and told us that we should visit the poor, the hungry, the prisoner. And we need to do that. And it's the heart of God for us to do that. And so anything that would inhibit us from doing that, we need to stand in prayer against those things and pray that God will open their eyes and remove the blindness, that they will see that God wants us to care for others because he cares for us. And so we are going to be committed to this in prayer and every way can to support this ministry because it's very important to who we are.
It's so exciting to get together with brothers and sisters in the Lord that are just reaching out and serving Jesus. Yes, we do have a common enemy at this particular time that's trying to stop us from doing the work of Jesus. And it's Board Bill 66. Now we need to stand together. We need to pray together. And again, if you haven't gotten a copy of it, call 314-881-3218 and ask when they're going to have the next luncheon. Get a copy of Board Bill 66. Get some literature. Find out what you can do. Get the names of the aldermen that are hearing this bill. It's, again, 314-881-3218. And please continue to pray for us here at the New Life Evangelistic Center right now. We need your prayers. Facing some tremendous financial needs. God is a God of miracles. And we just want to continue to reach out through the love of Jesus at this time, helping the hurting, helping the homeless. Please get involved now. You can send your much-needed tax-deductible gift to the New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, that's 63166. You can give online at newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. May God bless you in just such a special way as you just let your light so shine before men and women, they may see your good works and glorify our Father who's in heaven. We plan to have additional luncheons. We plan to rally. We plan to come together. We need your help. We need you to partner with us at New Life because this affects every church that wants to go out and do what Jesus told them to do. It affects every individual that wants to get involved and just doing the basic mandates of Scripture. Are we going to obey God? Are we going to obey men? Now, if it does pass the St. Louis Board of Aldermen, we're going to have another legal case. We already got one pending where they're trying to stop us from sheltering the homeless at 1411 Locust. So thank God for the courts, but that costs a lot of money also. But we can't give up. We've got to continue to remain steadfast. So during this remaining minute, will you please go to God in earnest prayer and then act on what the Holy Spirit speaks to your heart to share. Whether it's as a volunteer, whether it's as a prayer warrior, whether it's as an advocate calling 314-881-3218, or as one that will share from their gifts that are so urgently needed now with the New Life Evangelistic Center at P.O. Box 473, St. Louis, Missouri, 63166. Or you can give online with your credit card at newlifeevangelisticcenter.org. Thank you for praying, caring, and sharing at this critical hour. Thank you for letting your light so shine before men and women. They may see your good works and glorify our Father who's in heaven. Please stand with us right now. These are perilous times, and your prayers and direct involvement will make all the difference in the world. I want to thank God for those of you that are praying at this moment, those of you caring, those of you sharing. May God bless you in a special way.